Now, continuing on with part one, intermediate symbolism, we have again signs of Horus, Lucifer, and the 666 OK sign. This is a key image I use to show people that there's dual symbolism going here, and it's fantastic that she would use this on an album cover, because you can understand that there's dual symbology going on, and I'll show you that symbology. This is three sixes in the eye, so you can see that arrangement of three sixes in the eye of Lucifer. So you understand 666 means Satan or Lucifer. The eye, distinguishing that eye, means Horus or Lucifer. And then here we have this sign of silence being used. And that sign of silence, you're going to find out right now. We'll go into that sign rather than the 666 sign. This is Osiris in the middle, Isis, and Horus. And you see Horus puts the finger to the lips. Horus has a counterpart in Greece, which is Harpocrates. And you can see the finger going to the lip in that case. You can also see similarities between the adornment of these gods as well. Harpocrates or Horus, note the serpent and other symbols and figures around him. Notice also the finger to his mouth and the harp-shaped object on his head. The comedian Harpo Marx imitated this deity, and there is Harpo Marx, and he's doing the sign of Horus or Lucifer or Harpocrates. That's why he's named Harpo. But it just so happens that Oprah Winfrey has her studios called Harpo. There's dual symbolism here. Harpo refers to Harpocrates, I believe, and therefore Lucifer. Oprah is Harpo backwards, so you have now this dual symbology. They love to do things front and backwards. Backward masking in Satanism is key, so it was very well thought about of Harpo Studios. So you can see here, silence, the sign of silence. Here's a two-finger method, and I'll show you how they do it with variants of that. I believe this is African. I'm not sure there, but here we have Horus, Egyptian god. Oh, this is Osiris doing that sign. So we have different gods doing the same sign, but it all references that satanic trinity and these gods that have multiple disguises or manifestations. In Freemasonry, you have now the signs of silence. So now you have a reference to secret societies keeping silent about things, so that dual symbolism of keeping silent and the signs of Horus and Lucifer. Journal of the Masonic Society, now you can see the sign being done. Here's Harpocrates as a sculpture, sign of silence. You have a Masonic lodge in Oklahoma City. Now this is key as well, because you see now the Aeon, and the Aeon of Horus, or the Age of Horus. And you see Horus in the background, the hawk shape, and now you see this sign of silence, finger to the mouth. Aleister Crowley and secret societies, and you can see that that is the use of the sign of silence or the sign of Horus. You can also see the pyramid with eye at the top. This is Wicca, witchcraft, and you understand that by the crescent moon and the sun or the star there. Here is that sign of silence again. Down pointing usually means the female aspect or earth. So you'll see some of that later. You can see this priest. Alumbrados, Illuminati, and these monks and brothers. Now we have a reference to monks and brotherhoods, Jesuits and Jesuitism going all the way back through the Roman Empire. And so I'm going to hold that there, but this is Ignatius Loyola, who is the founder of the Jesuits. And you're going to understand what Jesuitism is, going from Jesuitism, Roman Empire, to Jesuitism, to with Gnosticism, and then through onto Freemasonry, founded by Jesuits. And we have Benedictus, and you see the sign of silence being used. Here is a Rosicrucian, so you can understand all of these secret societies, all of this stuff goes back, and Rosicrucianism is another secret society, and its roots in Gnosticism and monks and Jesuitism. R.C. Rosicrucian, and then you see the rosy cross being used. That's not a symbol of Christianity. And you see here again the use of that. Again, now you have the two middle fingers being put together in this portrait, and we'll get into that at the end of this whole thing. And you have you can see that stained glass window. Moving along, here is Horus, this god, and then you see all of this sacred geometry, all of these patriarchs of science and diplomacy and stature. And then you have now coming on through the, looks like, prelates and the Roman Empire, on through distinguished people like John Dee, who was in the court of Queen Elizabeth, and all of these dignitaries coming through, all of these elite coming through. What an image! And to show you that the sign of Horus now is being depicted on Mercury, the god Mercury. There he is. There's Mercury again. It looks like now this is the sort of Jewish seven candelabra. I forget what that's called now, just slipped my mind. But just to show you that there is a counterfeit going on, and they use the symbols of these things to twist your brain into thinking that it's all part of the same thing. And so I want you to understand that there's counterfeit going on, and please understand that concept fully as we move along. Over here we have a portrait. This is supposed to be Jesus. And you see the man here doing this sign of silence. Very interesting symbology going on. Even the fingers have that symbology. We'll see a little bit of that later. And you see this woman in the background with a finger to the mouth. Horus, again, the baby Horus. This is called Silence, the sculpture. And you see the hawks on both sides and the finger to the mouth. This portrait with the child and the finger to the mouth, the Masonic checkerboard floor, and you see a lot of this going on here. Very interesting. Colin Powell, Jewish Magic and Kabbalism, gives a due guard of the Royal Archmason. All these guys at the top level. He is a Mormon, and you're going to find out that Mormonism was founded by Freemasons. Winston Churchill, former Prime Minister of Great Britain, a Mason and a Druid priest, gives the sign of silence. Now, this is a key image here. You can understand now the use of the symbolism, dual use. She closes one eye to show you the eye of Lucifer, and then she does the same thing that Lady Gaga does on her album cover with the sign of Horus, and which is Lucifer. So that is a fashion shoot, and that's a studio image. And you can see the same thing going on. Basically, they're covering the eye instead of the OK sign in the eye, the 666 sign. Now, moving along with everyone doing the same thing, here is Rihanna. She actually tattooed "shh" on her finger. Lindsay Lohan did the same thing, as well as Lily Donaldson, doing the same thing, promoting the same thing. And now you can see them all doing it. This is amazing to me. And we don't get it, because this is a sign that they've made ubiquitous. Oh, shh, be quiet. That kind of thing. When you see it like this, and that she's closed her mouth with duct tape, and that she's giving the sign of the devil, then you can understand that's a dual symbolism there. This is that Lady Sovereign from the United Kingdom. Now, again, here's the studio shot of a young Michael Jackson. He does everything as well as this sign. So you understand that that is a deliberate sign of Horus, a.k.a. Lucifer. You saw that two-finger symbolism previously on this plate. And you can see Selena, Fergie, they all are doing it. Now, I can't say that this is probably, you know, like it's not a studio shot, so I don't want to say that he didn't do that and was caught there. But I'm telling you that they deliberately catch these artists doing these symbols just to show that allegiance. And when you see studio shots like this, you can understand that this is exactly what they're doing. So let's be reasonable about this, but I'm telling you, it's in the 90th percentile that this is what they're doing. And you saw Johnny Depp doing the other signs as well. David Bowie, disciple of Aleister Crowley, of course, he's going to do all of this. And we got to understand the full range of what they're doing. You see all of these artists, these puppets, these ministers for the religion, Blink 182, he's doing it, a variant of that, which is actually, I think, the right way, which is the finger on the mouth in that fashion. I just picked that up just by looking at what movies were out there, and Ben Stiller was there. Madonna. This is a, look at this. Now you can see, covering the eye, and she's doing the sign of Horus. Eye of Lucifer, sign of silence of Lucifer. Amazing to me. You can pick this out if you just know the symbols and what they mean. Don't be naive to this world. Understand that there is a doctrine of religion being perpetrated on mankind, completely perpetrated on mankind. Any which way you can do that, silent mode, however creative you can be. And there is a famous actress here on Japanese magazine. Now look at this. Here is the silence and the devil's sign. So you can understand that satanic sign, dual symbolism there. And look at this. This is an American Idol, Ryan Lambert. He wears Aleister Crowley's t-shirt, as did the Jonas brother, and he does the sign. Very clear, again, that what they're doing. This is that band My Chemical Romance. You remember the lightning bolt in the eye t-shirt for My Chemical Romance, and they do the same thing. They're all about symbology, and we're simply ignorant to it. Please inform yourself, educate yourself, because I believe that your soul is at stake. As a matter of fact, I am 100% sure your soul is at stake. And this man Jesus, that lived 2,000 years, that people ignore, that said he's God and said he's the only one, is the one that can save you. And that's my belief system. It doesn't have to be yours. Here's Charles Darwin, and you can see this deliberate photo shoot of him, photograph of him, and he's doing the sign of silence, the sign of Harpocrates or Horus, aka Lucifer. And you can see here now, see no evil, speak no evil, that kind of a thing, but you can see, understand now the one eye symbolism, the 666 OK sign, and the sign of Lucifer, or the sign of silence. Same thing. These are Japanese. It's global. Understand that. And I just wanted to make a final note. This is Darwin, and he is the founder of Darwinian evolution, which will take you completely away from understanding who God is. It's a completely planned doctrine to make you think that this whole thing is all purely naturalistic. We understand science. We can see what happens, but this is a manipulation of science based on things we've never seen. And I'm telling you, you're going to find out in the future in this presentation that our education has been owned. Science is literally owned and marketed to the public. And so if you're not a scientist, you have no particular say in things. And I'm telling you, if you just look with your eyes, and you can see that this particular doctrine that has come about in the last 2 centuries is off. And this clue as to who he's all about and what his purposes are is a clue to being very wary about what you believe. And this is a very touchy subject around the world with regard to faith and science. Now, with regard to Charles Darwin doing this hand sign, and this is, again, very deliberate. You can see this photo shoot, him in the corner. It was very deliberately done as a sign of silence. And so I believe this is a key image to understand he is the father of evolutionary theory. And evolutionary theory leads you away from the understanding of a supernatural God. So understand that there is a doctrine being taught. And if he is part of this secret society, then there is more than just your physical body at stake. What evolutionary theory has done throughout the ages, racism is a result of evolutionary theory, slavery, that slave trade was, social Darwinism, and believing that we need to now socialize our understanding because we're in cities now, and natural selection is not quite working within that, so we have to bring Darwinism into the social aspect. So understand what that's done and what the motive is behind that. And what I've come to find out, and you'll see in another plate with regard to religion and education at the end of that section, you're going to see that education is owned and operated. So there is an underlying jeopardy going on, and it is a fight for the soul and the idea and the understanding of religion, and this has now turned into pure atheistic evolution, and that's what communism is. They don't even allow any religious thought there. And so I don't know what category you're into, but look at this image and realize that there's something being perpetrated, and just wanted to make you aware of that.